What's going on, guys? Wingspan here, and welcome back to another redstone tutorial. Today, guys, I'm going to show you how to make this really cool skeleton face 3x3 piston door in Minecraft Pocket Edition. This is my design, and I've been messing with the 3x3 designs in my testing world over here. And I want to make a little face in 3x3 area, and I came up with 10 different designs, but the skeleton face was definitely my favorite. The only bad thing about this is that you can actually see a little bit of the sticky pistons over here at both sides, but in my opinion that doesn't really matter because the skeleton face itself looks absolutely amazing. So if you flick this lever you can see the opening and the closing over here, and they both look really cool, and it happens relatively fast. And the redstone thing for this is absolutely really simple. You can see over here we have the piston pretty much attached to our little lever over there with redstone block to pretty much unpower this redstone torch. And this redstone torch over here is pretty much what activates the whole circuit over here. And it's just a big loop of the redstone going across over here. So how this works is really simple. Once we deactivate this torch, this piston is going to be activated, allowing this piston to extend and retract really fast, so it pretty much sends a quick pulse, and it's going to push this sticky piston and the block on top of it over here, and it's going to retract this piston but leaving the block up over here. Then, because we have a little bit delay over here, this piston is going to push the next block over here, allowing the pistons to go up again using this observer over here. Then we have a couple of the sticky pistons on either side, three sticky pistons on this one and on this side over here. The redstone for that is really simple, just using some of the slabs to make a little redstone staircase, pretty much just connecting this piston without any of the delay. Then we have another double piston extender on the top, and pretty much the same thing on this side over here with the three sticky pistons without any delay. Then we have this redstone block over here with the sticky piston, pretty much sending the pulse to this sticky piston over here. And because we have the block with redstone, that's how these two blocks get powered. Then we have the observer block over here that's attached to the redstone, pretty much for the very last retraction of the door. So I can give you guys a quick example over here what's happening with the pistons. So if you push this lever over here, you can see it how it works over here. And when we do it again, you can see that this piston pushes first, then we have this piston pushing the block in the middle, pretty much setting these two blocks over here. Then we have the redstone going to these three sticky pistons, pretty much setting these three blocks of the door. Then we have the double piston extender at the top activating this door, and the final ones over here. And this redstone dust over here is for the very last retraction, as you can see over here. So when we activate it, it's pretty much the last retraction that happens at the door. And that's pretty much all there is for the redstone. It's a little bit big, but it's really simple, and I'm going to show you how to make it right now. So the blocks we're going to need for this are redstone, redstone torch, block of redstone, redstone repeater, sticky piston, observer, levers, some slabs, some block of our choice, and we're going to need some quartz stairs and quartz blocks for the skeleton face. Go ahead, start off by putting four sticky pistons facing up like this, and destroy the bottom two. So these sticky pistons over here are going to be our double piston extender. Then, to make it a little bit easier for us, we're going to make a little ring around this, making sure that we have a 3x3 space in the middle. And then, once we finish the redstone, we can pretty much go ahead and make the skeleton face. So just go ahead and encase this over here with a little ring with the block of your choice, making sure that we have 3x3 area over here. Then we're going to put our remaining pistons, and the first one is going to be over here, so pretty much the bottom right corner. We need the sticky piston facing towards this block like so. Then we're going to put the sticky pistons that we need at the either side and on the top. So just go ahead, do it like this, and pretty much face all of them into the block of your choice. Then go ahead over here at the middle, we need the double piston extender, so just go ahead, put a couple of the blocks up like that to allow us to put the double sticky pistons over here facing into the middle block at the top. Then final, we need these three sticky pistons over here, pretty much mimic what we have at this side over here. So just go ahead and do it like so, and then we can start and work on the redstone. So for the redstone, the first thing we need is of course our redstone torch, which is going to activate the whole circuit. We need to make sure that this redstone torch is not in the touch with this sticky piston, so make sure it's one block lower. Then we need to put a couple of the blocks like this, and the third one going up over here. Then we need to go ahead and put a couple of the redstone dust like so going into this block with the redstone torch on top of it and at the side over here. Then just go ahead and put the blocks on top of the redstone torches over here. Then we're going to go ahead and put the sticky piston on top of this torch over here with the block over here. And pretty much once we deactivate, this is going to be the piston which is going to send a quick pulse to this piston over here. Then we need to go ahead, put the block over here, and have the observer pointing down into this sticky piston over here. So make sure it's pointing down like so. And we pretty much need to go ahead and add another redstone torch on top of this block over here, and put another block on top of that. Then we need to add a little bit of the delay to this piston. So just go ahead, put the first one on 3 tick delay, and another repeater without of the delay over here. Then we need to go ahead and connect the redstone to these blocks over here. So just go ahead, put the block of your choice like so. Then we can just go ahead and use some of the slabs to pretty much make a little redstone staircase like so. Then just go ahead and connect all of that with the redstone dust like this. Then we can go ahead and add the block of your choice on top of the sticky piston, pretty much activating this piston over here. Then we need another block like so, and we need the observer one block away from this piston over here, and put the redstone in front of it. Then go ahead and connect the redstone from these slabs over here to the observer. Then we need to go ahead and add a couple of the blocks like this, and another one on top of this sticky piston. And we pretty much need to go ahead and connect the redstone from here to up there. So again, we're going to use some of the slabs. So just go ahead, bring this slab like this, and we can lower it by 2. Then just go ahead, destroy this one, and that's going to allow us to pretty much put the redstone on top of it. Then we need to add a little bit of the delay over here. So pretty much 2 redstone repeaters set to 3 tick delay, so the max tick delay over here. Then go ahead, grab yourself some block of your choice, and pretty much make a little staircase going down like this. And go ahead and put another block over here, so we can pretty much add the sticky piston like so, and make sure that it's one block above of this sticky piston like so. Then we can just go ahead and because this block is going to get activated, we don't need to put redstone on top of it. We can just go ahead and do it like this. So we can just go ahead, connect that to the piston, and we need to add ourselves the block of the redstone over here. Then we need to go ahead, put the block of your choice on the side of this piston over here, and go ahead, add the redstone like that, and that's going to activate these 2 sticky pistons over here. Then for the final thing, we need to go ahead and add the observer block over here pointing down. Then we need the block next to this sticky piston over here, and another block over here which is going to have the redstone dust on top of it. And the final thing that I kind of forgot is the repeater over here. So you can see at these pistons, at this side we have the redstone dust, and on this one we need to have the repeater set to 3 tick delay. So that's going to make our double piston extender. So we have 3 ticks delay on this one and 6 tick delay on the top over here. So that's pretty much all we need. Then we can just go ahead and add the lever over here and activate it to make sure that everything works. So you can see that opens really nicely and closes really nice over here. Then just go ahead, leave it closed like this, and you can see that these are the 9 blocks that we're gonna use for our 3x3 door. So just go ahead and carve that blocks out like this, and we can make ourselves the skeleton face. So we pretty much need to go ahead and grab our quartz blocks and quartz stairs over here and start making the face. So to make the face, we need the top left and right corner over here to be upside down stairs like this. So go ahead, do it like that, and that's going to be our eyes of the skeleton. Then go ahead, put the block of the quartz in the middle like that, and put another block over here, because that's going to help us to put the other stairs in the position a little bit easier. So you can see at for the ice we have the upside down stair going in this direction. Now we pretty much need to go ahead and add it going in this direction over here. So just go ahead and do it like that. Then we can pretty much remove the block from the middle over here. For the mouth, we pretty much need to make like a little soft design. So just go ahead and do it like that. And finally, for the nose, we need to add a normal stair like that. And make sure that you don't have it upside down. Otherwise, you can see that it's going to connect and it's not really going to make a skeleton face. So just make sure that it's a normal stair like that. And you get yourself a really nice skeleton face over here. Then we can just go ahead, use the block of our choice to pretty much cover the redstone up. So just go ahead and cover the redstone like this and pretty much make a little platform. So the final thing we need to do is pretty much go ahead and add the lever at the top, so you can pretty much put it at any block that you want, but for now I'm just going to put it right in front of the door. Then we can just go ahead down here and I believe it's this block over here. So just go ahead, put the sticky piston and the block of redstone like that, and we can pretty much just go ahead and connect the redstone to the redstone torch, so we can pretty much activate the whole circuit from up there. And you can pretty much go ahead and do the same on this side, but for now I'm just going to go ahead and leave it at the front of the door. Then you can just go ahead over here and click it to make sure that everything works. So you can see it opens really nicely and closes too. So the last thing you can do over here, just go ahead and open it. You can see that this block is not going to move and it's pretty much useless. So you can pretty much just go ahead and replace it with the stair so it matches this side over here. And these two blocks over here have a little bit of the redstone on top of them, but they're not matching this white circle that we have. So just go ahead and destroy it and replace that with the quartz block like this, and we can pretty much just go ahead and replace the redstone on top of it. So we need the redstone dust on top of this one over here, and the redstone repeater set to 3 tick delay over here, so pretty much the max tick delay over here. So then go ahead and activate it one more time to make sure that everything works, and as you can see it works perfectly, and you get yourself a really amazing 3x3 piston door with the skeleton face on it. So that's pretty much all there is for this redstone tutorial. If you guys have enjoyed it, make sure to leave a like and subscribe if you're new to my channel. It really does help a lot. Hope you enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching and peace out.